Here's a ranking of the top 5 books on consciousness. Starting with number 5, The Prefrontal Cortex, by Joaquin Fuster, is a great book that explores the unfamiliar territory at the front of the brain. What I took away from this book was the entirely new concept that the brain makes a viewer/interpreter of consciousness which also responds to it. It feels like there is a viewer of consciousness because there is, ostensibly in the prefrontal cortex. Fuster explores how high-level sensory regions of the brain have fascicular paths to and from the prefrontal cortex. Coming in at 4th place is My Stroke of Insight, by Jill Taylor. Jill is a neuroscientist who had a severe hemorrhage in her left hemisphere and describes in exquisite detail the hour-by-hour losses to being able to speak what she mentally intended or look for a pattern on a card that she had a clear mental image to match against. She eventually lost all language, math, color, and 3D skills and had to begin again like a newborn in learning these things. Her book is particularly good because it helps to localize where language, lexical ability, color, depth, and anything involving comparisons typically resides in the brain, the left hemisphere. She also describes how it feels for the left side to shut up for once and let the right side experience a consciousness that simply is, within the present moment, blissful and loving. At 3rd place is Jeff Hawkins' 1000 Brains, A New Theory of Intelligence. This book explores possible mechanisms for doing spatial transforms from one relative axis set to another. For example, when you consider a coffee cup, it seems to have its own up axis regardless of the orientation at which you hold it. Similarly, each patch of skin on your hand and each pixel on your eye's retina has its own orientation vector pointing outwards, as well as its own spot within perceptual space. It also explores how sparsity could serve as a very useful brain tool, that there is a group of neurons dedicated to represent some spot within perceptual space or some spot on an object, but even if only half or less of the neurons of the group fire, there is still recognition of the thing with very little chance of false positives. Jeff also points out that the cortex is basically a single column repeated thousands of times. If we can figure out the circuitry of one column, we may have figured it all out. Also, since the circuitry appears the same everywhere, the cortex appears to be doing the same operation of all modalities of sensation and movement. He thinks this is a sort of abstraction of the data that stores all relationships as well as possible. Of course, each column must ostensibly understand every point within perceptual space, and my thought is that the world is made to pass through this fixed perceptual space when you go for a walk. At 2nd place is Rodolfo Yunas' book, I Have the Vortex. Vortex in this case means the sort of inside-out turn going from thalamus to cortex and back, continually. Yunas believes this cortico-thalamo-cortical recurrent circuit is the seat of consciousness. It makes sense to me, as it is apparently the only thing that brings all sense and motor modalities together in a single, ongoing circuit. Francis Crick, the co-discoverer of DNA, also speculated that this may be the seat of consciousness, with a special place for the so-called posterior hot zones of the parietal-occipital-temporal meetup zone. Anyway, Rodolfo Yunas proposes that this circuit occurs at 40 Hz, but he also mentions a 10 Hz oscillation that the inferior olive starts by itself, and a 2 Hz firing pattern from inferior olive to cerebellum. I feel like these 2 Hz and 10 Hz oscillations may be passed up through brainstem and cerebellum to create frames of focal consciousness as part of the 40 Hz circuit between thalamus and cortex. Yunas explains consciousness as being bound by the pulsate, robotic frequencies, as if they are shouting, move, 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 like an internalized version of the first flagella of early life. He gives an example of how transcranial stimulation made him move his foot inwards medially, whilst giving the sensation that he had decided to do it. He defines free will as those times when you know what your body is going to do next. Finally, at 1st place is Jeff Hawkins again, with his older book, On Intelligence. In it, he beautifully points out how behavior and sensation are made to happen, and then get recorded so that new behaviors and sensations can be predicted. He posits that consciousness is largely made up of novel experience, memory, and prediction. This is copacetic to me because it fits in with ring theory, that there is an ever-growing helix which continually moves from present into future in a predictive, but malleable, fashion, and which, by patterns, paints both sensation and action in one as a 3D consciousness video. More is available in my book Rings of Fire, How the Brain Makes Consciousness.